Now, the Department of Justice is reportedly looking into abuses of power by large telecom companies like AT&T and Verizon. And we want to know if the exclusivity of the iPhone will be struck down. So let's explore it right now in The Loop. All right, joining me from New York to help us make sense of it all, senior writer for CNET, Maggie Reardon is here. How are you, Maggie?
I'm doing well.
Great, thank you. The Wall Street Journal has reported that the Department of Justice began this internal review into whether telecom companies like AT&T and Verizon, whether or not they've created a monopoly. I mean, I don't know why they need to bother with the review for that, but that's fine. Let's assume that this story is true. Maggie, what are they actually looking for?
Well, they're looking to see if they've broken any laws. You know, for example, the Sherman Act, which is a violation of antitrust. So that's, I mean, specifically they're looking at that.
Well, yeah, specifically, so Sherman Act is antitrust, but for the I'd say 99% of our audience who has no idea what that means, what's a potential way they could violate that?
Perfectly honest, I mean, it's difficult to prove that they are a monopoly because there are other competitors, right? I mean, there are other phone companies. I mean, there are four wireless companies. There are lots of different cable companies that compete with them. So to call them a monopoly is probably not really accurate, but are they sort of colluding together to control the market? That's probably what the DOJ is really looking for,
right,
to see if they're exerting any kind of pressure on the market to jack up prices or keep other smaller competitors out of the market. Maggie, someone at the
DOJ, they just got their cube, they're all set up, they got their name placard all nice and straight, and they took out their BlackBerry and they decided they wanted to play touchscreen Peggle on an iPhone, and they got really upset, so now they decided they're going after AT&T. I mean, isn't that what this boils down to, is AT&T in the iPhone, the fact that it's the only carrier you can get it on?
Well, I think that has probably brought to light a lot of this stuff. I think that there are a lot of people complaining that the iPhone is only available on AT&T. Whether that's something that's broken any laws, I don't know. I guess that's what the DOJ is going to be looking at. But I think it's fair to say that the iPhone is clearly the most important phone that's out there, and it's very popular, and people are certainly onto it.
Could an investigation also look at whether or not, like, the telecom companies, are they improperly restricting services on their network? Because that's another big portion of this, right?
Yeah, and to be honest with you, I think that's probably where there's a stronger argument. If you look at AT&T, for example, and the iPhone, they keep a lot of services off of that. For example, Skype is kind of handicapped on the App Store, and so is the Sling Player. You can only use it in Wi-Fi hotspots. But at the same time, they're letting the Major League Baseball stream their games live. So it doesn't really make a lot of sense. They're kind of picking and choosing who they let stream certain things. And that's not a good thing. I mean, that's, consumers definitely don't want to see something like that.
Sure. So if I am AT&T and I saw this news, other than throwing an office chair through a window, how do I react? Do I mount a case? Do I all of a sudden say, hey, you know what, I don't want the government interfering with this business right now, I'm going to let Skype go through? Could this be could this be a win for consumers?
Yeah, I think it can be, because if you look back to what's happened in the past, when the government starts to exert a lot of power or threaten things, I mean, you've already got Congress looking into this, the FCC is looking into this, now the DOJ, they'll probably start to make a move on their own. The phone companies don't want to be regulated, so they're going to do as much as they can to sort of regulate themselves. So if they see that everybody's kind of, pissed off at them, they'll probably, back off a little bit.
Right.
And then that could be a good thing for consumers.
And just to be clear, Maggie, I still can't send picture messages on my iPhone, right? That's still, despite this story, I still can't do it.
Not yet.
Okay, just wanted to make sure.
Not yet.
I hope the DOJ gets in there. I really do. Thank you, Maggie, so much for joining us. Really appreciate you keeping us in the loop.